Autism is a complex neurodevelopmental condition with traits and symptoms that may occur along a wide spectrum.
Autism is a way of describing individuals' behavior. It's challenging to describe in part because it's a spectrum, in fact, quite a wide spectrum. And it goes from individuals with what some people call profound autism, individuals who may not be verbal, who may actually hurt themselves physically, who may have other associated medical problems like epilepsy on the one extreme, to other individuals who are just incredibly talented. Oftentimes, though, they have challenges across the entire spectrum in terms of social connectivity, being able to either engage or connect with other individuals, or in some cases, really feeling like they feel safer or more secure when things are the same and consistent. And so within that very wide spectrum, we're trying to make people's lives better.
Today, researchers are harnessing the power of big data to study autism better. By partnering with many individuals with autism and their families, researchers can understand and develop more precise approaches to medical and behavioral challenges.
As a researcher, I think of big data as a large multidimensional data set on tens of thousands of people. And by bringing all these together, I think that one, as a researcher, can have a much deeper understanding of the patterns that might arise and might manifest in a population with a condition versus people without it.
Although we say big data, what it really is little bits of data coming from big, large numbers of people. And so it's all of us together that makes it big.
Research needs to reflect an accurate and authentic representation of individuals with autism. To do so, researchers aim to reach as many people as possible. SPARK is the biggest autism research study ever. Launched in 2016, SPARK is on a mission to advance the understanding of autism.
The Simons Foundation launched SPARK because we knew that in order to make meaningful progress towards our mission of better understanding autism and getting to better outcomes for people with autism, that we needed a really, really big data set from tens of thousands of people with autism. We knew when we started this that autism is extremely heterogeneous in the way it presents, but also at a genetic level. So we knew that it's not a condition where there are one or two or three genes involved. There are probably several hundred to even 1,000.
Participants are the heart and the soul. They are SPARK. They are really what sparks everything that comes from this. An important part of what comes from this is also what we call research match, the opportunity for researchers around the world to partner with our participants and answer, in some cases, hundreds of research questions that the community and the researchers have to move forward. So it's not just all what I call SPARK Central, but it's really uniting the entire research community.
As a researcher, you're looking at that heterogeneity. The only way to make sense of it and to make patterns emerge from the data is to have a lot of it.
The basic idea is that for any one person, we make it easy to do in terms of being able to just do it at your computer.
So SPARK became the biggest research study in autism through the hard work of hundreds of thousands of people. There are many people in the United States that are working at our different clinical sites to recruit people, and they've touched tens of thousands of people. And so through word of mouth and through hard work from lots of people, we've created this really large resource and data set that's open to all researchers across the world so that we can make progress together in understanding autism.
SPARK is the next step in autism research. By dramatically increasing the number of participants in its research study, SPARK is making important progress in autism possible.
Participation in SPARK is private between you and SPARK. So you get to choose who you share your participation with. So none of the data that someone receives through SPARK or gives to SPARK will ever be shared with any other medical professional unless that participant chooses to share it with their own doctors.
So SPARK would like to be able to leave no one behind. So we really have taken a serious approach at being able to increase our diversity and our equity and make sure that we're inclusive. Because we are such a wonderfully rich and different community, we need to be able to have all that richness represented.
So as a parent of someone with autism, I think that it's just important to try to participate in research. I know that it's hard, but I think by participating and contributing data, we can work together to get to a better understanding of autism and get to better treatments for autism and help other people one day.
Join Spark today.